Good day, everybody. Let's talk about geological strength index. So this is something that we use together with generalized Hoek-Brown-Feli criteria. I have a video how we can analyze results from triaxial tests using a special case of Hoek-Brown-Feli criteria. Please watch that one. That's pretty helpful. And in this video, we'll talk about what is GSI, how we can use it, and we're going to look at this example. We're actually going to look at this rock mass and try to characterize it using GSI. So this is the chart that we use. So it was published by Hoek and Marinus in 2000. So that's one of the major ones. You can probably see slightly different variations of this chart, maybe with a little bit of more details and information. So it's used very common in mining engineering. So I think if you know how to use it, that will be advantages for you. So what we actually need to do is we just need to assess the structure of the rock mass, and we also assess the conditions of the joints, so soft conditions. So this GSI was developed by these researchers. They look at hundreds or maybe thousands of rock walls and tunnels and mining, and that's the kind of chart they came up with. So for structure, we would see something like intact or massive rocks. So in this case, this is actually very good because not many joints, which means that overall strength of rock mass will be very high. And in this case, GSI will be pretty high. So let's say if no joints, GSI can be even 100, but of course, usually it never happens in real life. There is always joints, maybe one or two large ones. So in this case, GSI will be still pretty high. It also depends on the conditions of joints. Usually when we have only one or two joints, this discontinuities. This means that rock mass, it's not weathered much. So in this case, you will see really rough and fresh surfaces. So usually you will have ND square. Then as the weathering process goes on, we're going to see more joints. In this case, structure will be blocky, and also depends on the conditions. Usually more weathering means that will decrease the properties of joints, so that will be good, become good. Then if there is even more weathering, you see here we have moderately weathered joints. In this case, the surface conditions can be called as fair, poor, and very poor. So in general, it kind of goes this way. Also, when they introduced the charts, so they're saying that if GSI is less than 20, that is actually very difficult to assess. So usually you will see that values of GSI usually 20 or higher. So that's where it really works well, this chart. If we have rock structure, which is like this one, laminated, sheared, disintegrated. So in this case, GSI doesn't work really well. Okay, so now let's look at what we have here in this picture. Just one of the rock slopes along a major road. So I took picture a few years ago. So what we can do now, we just look at the structure. So we'll see that it's rock mass, but it was weathered. So we have lots of discontinuities here. I'm just going to highlight them so that you can see that clearly, right? So I have a little bit here, a few joints here. So to me, it's more very blocky. So that's how it looks like to me. And we, when we look at the rock surface of the conditions, so actually it was moderately weathered. So that will be moderately weathered here. So in this case, very blocky, moderately weathered. So we're gonna have points here. So GSI of this rock mass will be about 45. Usually we give a range, so we give plus minus 5, right? So another thing that I need to mention, so this GSI, it's a little bit subjective. It depends how you assess it. So different researchers or engineers would look at it slightly differently. The way they will assess surface conditions or structure, it can be also very different assessment, but not that much. So for that reason, we give a range. So if I were here to investigate the GSI of this rock mass, I would probably come with the value of 45 plus minus 5. So maybe like 50, 45, 50, I would probably go like that. Okay, thanks for watching this video. Well, if you walk around and see rock masses, just try to estimate GSI as a practice. Have a nice day. Bye.